I don't know what to say, but I'm here with Todd Sinclair. This is unbelievable. Unbelievable. Wow. Heather's coming downstairs to look, so we're gonna get her reaction. Isn't that amazing?
I haven't even taken it all in yet.
I haven't taken it all in yet.
Is this just stream of consciousness?
These words?
I don't know. I mean, I think that they're themes that I have that I've been using a lot, so.
Isn't that awesome?
I love that you fearlessly just used the whole page.
Bird heads.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yep.
I don't know what those cool. were, though.
Those were like little registration marks. Oh, okay, yeah, I was just looking at this. I said, what was that little thing? So this just comes in your head and you just write it down?
Reference points that to be honest, almost then it becomes like more poetry, but the themes are all things I think about. And there are buildings too, like you had those buildings, and I was thinking I do a lot with the buildings.
Oh yeah, you already have a lot of this imagery.
Exactly. It's just, so it's all very threaded into a...
Wow, it's just part of it.
Yep. The buildings on this side, it's very, you know, so when I saw that, I imagined it was UMass, yours.
That's kind of how I envisioned it too. I don't know if it is, but...
No, it's just generic.
There's a hare in the next pond. I'd like to go see it. No.
Just trying to get up my sleeve.
You get a picture.
Oh, here we go.
On a mission.
I painted on the purple, but it's a little too transparent. I'm gonna mix up a new batch, hand painted over what I stenciled. Well, I hit a roadblock when I put in the purple stencil. It was the wrong color, set everything off. Try to lighten that shade up and paint it or just redo everything. So with the whole evolution of this where I'm not sure what to do next. But there is things to do just to move forward with the progress, like here and the green and the blue over here. This blue and here, go ahead and cut those and, you know, make a decision about this purple up here. I have this sketch here that I like, so not even add the purple here. But when I go ahead and mat it, I mean, that looks fine. The trees look fine. So my own subjective opinion of what I'm seeing at any given time, whether I like it or not. I mean, that's just my own subjective opinion. I might do things that people don't like, or I could do things people like that I don't like. So I guess the whole key to it is you just keep moving forward and try to refine it as you go. You know, the time will come when, and eventually if you keep working on it, the whole thing is done fully at that point, and it looks good to other people. So I'm back to this conundrum. At what point do you cut the stencil, and at what point do you paint? That's the goal. How do you blend those two together? And I'll be happy with both of them. Looks good to me. So right now, I'm just gonna paint. I'll have a painting and the stencils will match. Then I'll just keep doing that back and forth, refining the stencils, and eventually I'm gonna just keep on painting and cutting stencils, and it'll probably be 2 more weeks before. That shapes it?
Mm-hmm.
And that's solid wool?
Yep. It started out like this.
Yeah.
And then just by using the needles, I just poked it until it gets more and more condensed and
so you shape. There's nothing inside that.
It's just wool.
And you shape it by poking it with a needle?
Yep.
And it just changes and does stuff, and you made that?
Yep.
How do you stick the pink yarn to the purple?
You just by using the same method, you just use the wool. You can compress it, you know, to make a little shape to start with, like I'm doing, or you can, you know, do it different ways. Just kind of mats onto each other. You just keep poking it, and it just sticks to itself.
All these different colors.